skin rash differential diagnosis. There is wide differential diagnosis of skin rash, and it's so difficult to cover it all, and there is many algorithm of the skin rash. Hopefully this algorithm can help. Start by, if it's you can't identify what the type of the rash, if you see it, and if you can't identify from the complaint any approach, please put this first differential diagnosis in your mind. Put dermatitis, which usually through drug induced or less common due to inspect by. But dermatitis herpetiform, which is came with a celiac disease. But dermatomyositis, erythema nodosum and erythema multiform, vasculitis like purpura or Hodgkin line or cryoglobulinemia or arthritis nodosa, just but vasculitis. Infection, but in your mind endocarditis or meningitis, less common herpes zoster. Malignancy, less common. Rash, vasculitic rash also, and you can't undivide both hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia in your mind. Less common neurofibromatosis and tuberous sclerosis. If you ask and you found that this rash increase after trauma, this is mean Kuebner phenomena positive, both in your mind psoriasis, lichen planus, vitiligo, pemphigoid, necrobiosis lipotica, and bioderma gangrenosa. If it's photosensitive, what in your mind systemic lupus, erythematosus, psoriasis, dermatomyositis, pemphigoid vulgaris, porphyria cutanea tarda. Any skin rash start as a bully or plaster, these four is mandatory to think about: pemphigoids and pemphigoid, dermatitis herpetiform, and porphyria cutanea tarda. Usually the rash in extensor, it will be psoriasis or dermatitis herpetiform, but in the flexor it will be lichen planus or contact dermatitis or eczema. For skin pigmentation, there is wide differential diagnosis. For example, skin pigmentation all over the body, think about Addison disease, Nelson syndrome, think about hemochromatosis, Kofidioelate with due to neurofibromatosis or tuberous sclerosis, Cushing, porphyria cutanea tarda, and chronic disease, rheumatological or renal or liver, fixed drug eruption, especially with amiodarone. But if the pigmentation buccal or in the oral cavity, think about Addison, Nelson syndrome, lichen planus, less common, Peetz jugular, and smoker melanosis and melanoma. For hypopigmentation, think about vitiligo, very important, but don't exclude in your mind scleroderma, which is also very, very common, at least as a physician diagnosis. Ash leaf spots of the tuberous sclerosis and discoid lupus, very, very, very important, especially with this clinical consultation station. For ulceration, for mouth ulcer, which is very common, to come, think about many causes like Behçet's disease, pemphigoid vulgaris, erosive lichen planus, drug-induced Steven Johnson, especially with tetracycline, celiac or Crohn's disease, vitamin deficiency or systemic lupus, trauma or tumor, infection, especially HIV, very important, drug-induced especially steroid or aldrenoid as bisphosphonate is very, very important. Skin rash in the lower limb, bioderma gangrenosum, it's came, necrobiosis lipotica, peritibial myxedema is very important, it's came, erythema nodosum, it's came frequently, erythema multiform, and venous insufficiency or arterial or neuropathic abnormality of vascular or trauma or tumor or drug induced as usual. For the skin lesion in the face, don't exclude discoid lupus, this is the most common differential diagnosis. Lupus perino, lupus vulgaris to be mentioned in the differential diagnosis. Telangiectasia is very important. Raynaud's phenomena, vasculitis, ischemia, and other common causes we mentioned as usual, trauma, tumor, infection, and drug induced. Any telangiectasia in your face, both in your differential diagnosis, mitral stenosis and mixed edema. But if another area, not only in the face, hereditary hemorrhagic telangiectasia is very, very important. It's the most common cause of telangiectasia and it came frequently. And systemic lupus, scleroderma and dermatomyositis.